wrestling with infinity.
Wow.
Just as the planets move relative to the stars from day to day, it turns out that the stars too are moving relative to each other. So the celestial sphere I have on my desk is just a snapshot of the night sky at a particular moment.
Wow, so cool.
Marked on my sphere is the easily identifiable constellations of the Plough or Big Dipper. But the star that make up the Plough, Merak, Dabuhe, Alcaide, Fekka, Megules, Ariotos, Mizar, are on the move. 100,000 years ago, they would have been painted on my globe in very different configuration, and 100,000 years hence, they will look different again.
Wow. Because it's a snapshot, right?
But for the ancient astronomers, the stars were fixed, bound to the celestial sphere that encompassed the universe.
Yeah, this is all about Greek, right?
Yes. There was a little discussion of what lay beyond. This was the void where there was nothing. Beyond the limits of my paper model was a no-go area. However, there were some medieval philosophers who were prepared to contemplate the nature of the void. Nicolas Oresme believed that the extra cosmic space beyond the celestial sphere really existed and was infinite in extent. In his writing, he identified this immensity with God. Not so far, perhaps, from my proposed conception of the God as the things we cannot know. Oresme was not frightened by the philosophical challenge of the infinite. Indeed, he proved that you can reach infinity by adding the fractions 1 + 2 + 1 + 1/2 + 1/4 + 1/3 + 1/4 + ... A counterintuitive mathematical result, given that the bits you are adding are getting smaller and smaller. This infinite sum is known as a harmonic series.
Yes, harmonic series. This is all about music, right?
Because when I pluck a string on my cello, the sound is built from harmonics whose wavelengths are given by all these fractions.
Wow, it's so beautiful.
So the numerator, denominator increase one by one, right? As I explained later.
Oh, just a moment. 1 + 1/2 + 1/3.
So as you sum more and more, the new term which is added to this formula is going to be zero. As I explained later, the revelation that this harmonic series sums to identify has interesting repercussions for how far we may ever be able to see into space.
Really?
Wow. It seems that it was only in the 15th century that astronomers began to contemplate the idea that the celestial sphere might be an illusion and that the universe might extend infinitely. Nicolas Cusanus suggested that the universe was infinite and any point could therefore be considered its center. This was picked up by the Italian Dominican friar Giordano Bruno, who in 1584 wrote a seminal work on the infinite universe and worlds. The universe is then at once infinite, immobile, it is not capable of the comprehension and therefore is endless and limitless. And to that extent, infinite and indeterminable, and consequently immobile.
Wow.
Yeah, it's getting hotter.
Bruno's logic that leads to this conclusion is interesting. The universe is created by God, but God is unknowable. Therefore, the universe must be beyond our comprehension. Therefore, it must be infinite, since a finite universe is in theory knowable. Now, I would say that the converse is true, really. If the universe is endless, it means that potentially it is beyond our comprehension. And if I am exploring the concept of God as a way of articulating the things we cannot know, then an infinite universe, if unknowable, could imply the existence of this concept of the transcendence. But is the universe infinite? And if so, is it as unknowable as it may first appear? Who is it? Bruno offers more than just his belief in God to justify his view of an infinite universe. One of the most powerful challenges to an infinite universe contained in a celestial sphere is the question of what is behind the world that contains the universe. Many suggested that there is nothing, the void. But Bruno was dissatisfied with this. He also believed that time was infinite both in the past and into the future. This somewhat controversially did away with the needs for a moment of creation and a day of final judgment. Bruno was not shy of controversy, and his teaching on the Bible eventually led to him falling foul of Catholic Church. Not a good thing at the time. He was burned at the stake of 17 February 1600. He was burned. Really? Yeah, because this is about the church, right? Yo. Bruno's ideas raised the question of how I could ever know whether the universe is infinite. If it is finite, then it might be possible to know this. The surface of Earth turned out to be finite and navigable. So perhaps we can simply navigate our universe and prove that it is finite. Although we don't have a ship in which we can sail to the edge of the universe, scientists in the 17th century did come up with a cunning way to explore space. The telescope. Wow. It's all about engineering, right? It's not physics, it's engineering. Huh.